All your sockets and stuff in there, I suppose.
All of the metric stuff is in there. If it's any standard stuff, it's in the other box over here. So.
Yeah, the bad thing with GMs is you don't know what it's going to be.
No, exactly.
Yeah. I was so frustrated yesterday. I was like, why is some of this stuff standard?
Yeah. And we decided if we can't get the headers, if we can't get them off, we're going to take the saws off too.
Never use a 13 millimeter socket. About to scrap,
right.
Something's hard to get off, you know you don't need it.
You could just cut it.
Yeah, probably should.
Got some dikes.
There's one of the cutters. Those were the weapon of choice yesterday, many times.
Yeah.
Yeah, for shifting the loads, it sure helps.
It's about to get into your front bumper.
It's fine. It's all in one of the junk cart.
You just gashed the crap out of him. Okay.
Hey, I know what to do. Let the air out of the front tires.
Here
you go. Oh. Tara, go grab the chuck, the air valve. Four. It's over there somewhere. Top of that tire. Let these front tires get it out.
I said, well, you don't get jacked up and take the tires off.
That's all I'm getting.
tires on too.
Yeah.
I noticed that yesterday. I was like, this thing has good tires on.
They don't fit your truck. I think the truck's taking too hard.
Out. It is ugly. If there's a heart of an LS and under there, I'd like to see it because it's pretty ugly. That's what's left of the frame.
Black when I got them.
Oh yeah.
I had to clean them. There's the center caps. Two of them are still black.
Okay.
So.
Well, I can take the front center caps.
Yeah. No.
Because I'm gonna basically R17s are gonna get not used. All right. Go to the 18 square.
You gonna do that for mostly track only or just all the time?
All the time, I think. Well. The goal, we're doing that cars and cones thing that do. And Tara's gonna drive the Miata and I'm gonna drive the Corvette. And so I'm planning on putting 315 rivals on it for that all the way around. And then if the tires are still good, I'll put them over on the RX-7 and do the album right now.
This is a touch up that when Will is painted, but it's water based. So you have to put like clear touch up or clear, some kind of clear touch up over it.
Okay, cool.
Perfect. Give some leftover from when they painted it.
Okay. I'm telling you, be careful.
I feel like I'm gonna go down. What are those 15s?
That looks about right.
Fall down, make sure you're in the camera frame.
Oh, we gotta do the torque converter. We both hit and thought about it at the same time.
Because Brian said you put nitrous on it and stuff though?
Yeah, I did. Proton. Next. I haven't even hit it yet.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was gonna do some hot wide upper runs to get that part down in, and then and button doing the nitrous.
Yeah. Man, that thing is gonna be something.
Hope I get it back in tens on the motor like it should be.
Wow.
Yeah.
It wouldn't instant, but like it would just steadily keep climbing. Like as the engine warmed up, it just kept going, and boom, it would hit like 240 before you knew it.
And it would not cool down.
Actually, it stayed at about 240 for a while. And then
when you'd stop, it took you couldn't get it cooled down. It would take a while.
And then
that's what that's poured water in.
Well, and then I thought there was air in the system, and then induced air into the system because I popped the cap, and then it got real hot.
Yeah.
And we nursed it home.
It's fine. Show you.
Something else, like if there is an issue like that, last time with the mass airflow, if you're around someone that does that, just unplug the mass airflow sensor. He goes into speed density and doesn't do that.
They're so cheap now, too. It's unbelievable.
I want to get great gas mileage. They get about 30.
Yeah. Well, I've got now something. I'm getting 32. Hey, runs actually got some surprise the way it runs.
That thing's surprising. It gets 37.
Wow.
And it's that engine in that car is super torquey.
Yeah. That's why it helps, though. You got a lot of torque and you run a taller gear.
That thing's geared real short too. It's peppy because of the short gearing and the torque. It's surprising.
The Corvette is pretty good gas.
The Corvette, it's got 34.
Yeah, a lot of people are 6 feet.
We raced it up to Toledo a couple of years ago, and last year we trailered it everywhere. We had drove it to Toledo and then drove it home, and I reset the computer before we left Toledo, and running 78 miles an hour on cruise control the whole way home, we got 34.